is Claudia here from the Bookkeeping Experts. I'm back for more information on QuickBooks Online. Today we're going to teach you how to add cash transactions in QuickBooks Online in the most efficient way using a CSV format Excel file. So what to do? First, you want to make sure you record all your cash transactions into an Excel spreadsheet. We're going to talk about the formatting. Formatting is very important. And then how to transfer that information into QuickBooks Online. So some of you may be recording tips or just cash received, or maybe you are running to the store, you don't have your business credit card or payment, use your personal account, and you want to keep track of that in an efficient way, so you can enter that in a spreadsheet. And I'm going to teach you how to enter these transactions in the most efficient way, kind of like a bank transaction. So stay tuned. We're going to go ahead and connect with QuickBooks Online, but first I'm going to show you how to properly format that Excel spreadsheet so that when you integrate into QuickBooks or when you import into QuickBooks Online, it's going to work the way it's supposed to work. So we're going to keep it simple, but at the same time with enough details for us to be able to categorize those transactions in QuickBooks Online. So here we go. All right, so we are going into the Excel spreadsheet first. So let me change this. Okay, so this is my Excel spreadsheet. And as you can see here, it has to be the right format. If you don't have the right format here, you're not going to be able to import into QuickBooks Online. So, usually I put the date, okay? And the second column here, I'm going to click on description. And on the third column, I'm going to put both negative and positive amounts. So I'm going to call amount. Now, if you want two columns, one for positive and one for negative, you can do that as well. You can call deposit and credits and then put, you know, whatever deposit, positive amount under deposit and credit as far as expense goes, go into the credit column. I like to keep everything in one column. Keep in mind, if it is an expense, you want to put a negative amount. And if it is income, you just leave it as a positive amount. And it's going to work out as a deposit into the cash account. Oh, yes. And when you save the file, you want to make sure you save it as a CSV format in Excel. So it's just the type of format that you want to save that will allow you to import those transactions in QuickBooks. Okay. All right, so let's go to QuickBooks right now. Okay, so we look into our format, into our Excel spreadsheet. The next thing to do is to create a cash account. If you have not created before, we're going to click on New. And we're going to call it Cash on Hand, but I'm going to select a bank account here. So this time it is a bank account. And we're going to call it Cash on Hand. All right, so that's all there is to it. We're going to go ahead and save it. And so I have my bank account here. And the next thing you want to do is click on Transaction, Bank Transaction. And see where it says link account? I'm going to click on that arrow over here. And I'm going to upload it from file. Okay, so we find our file over here. We want to go ahead and select the file. And continue. And here we're going to select the bank. We're going to go ahead and select the cash account. Go ahead and click on continue. And remember, there's only one column for both income and expense. So I'm going to go ahead and select one column and the date format. I put as month, MM, slash DD, and for the year. We want to go ahead and select the date, description, and amount. On the description, you can put something that will tell you what this is going to be categorized as. So this is going to help you very much. So you want to go ahead and make sure you have a description under that file. And I'm going to select all these transactions. See, all the negative amount is going to be expenses, and the positive amount is going to be income. I'm going to go ahead and select all of them and continue. And we're going to accept those 13 transactions. And when I do it like that, we're going to go ahead and click on done. My cash transaction is now going to show up on my main bank feed, and I can categorize those transactions just like I categorize anything and even create rules for those transactions. So when you add those transactions at the end of the month, it will automatically be categorized as such. So look at this. This one I'm going to go ahead and select that this was office expense, and I can, like I said, I can create a rule just like any bank account here, and I can put Amazon cash, and we're gonna go ahead and click on Amazon. Look at here, I can even test, and it's gonna have two transactions here. I want to make sure only the account cash is selected, or I can select all the accounts if you want to. Look at this. So I can go ahead and save that, automatically save and categorize. Isn't that cool? Same thing as tips. If you want to make sure you keep track of who you're paying, then you don't want to select any rule for that. But if you don't, if you just want to put this on a lump sum or put it towards your tips liability, you're just going to put employee, and this is going to go to tips payable. So you're paying your employees or undistributed tips, which is a liability account. You're paying your employee tips, and when you pay out of the cash account, you're taking away that liability. So if you pay your employees cash tips, you want to make sure you keep track of that. And if you want to put their name under the description, you can put something like the name of the employee, tips, and then you know how to categorize here. Office Depot, office expense. I can also create a rule for that. And how cool is that? So this is the most efficient way to enter those cash transactions. Because you don't want to do one by one. You want to make sure that you are efficient. Okay, so Office Depot, cash. We can test my rule here. There's one, only one. And it's going to, you want to make sure you put the payee, by the way, because you want to keep track of all your payees and save. And Verizon, it automatically figure out that that's what it is. I can create Verizon. Okay. I can now, when you create rules, make sure that you create only rules to those transactions that is always, always, always going to be the same. So please do not create rules for transactions that will be categorized differently in the future. Maybe, like Amazon, you have to be careful, unless you always, 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 always categorize those transactions as office expense or whatever expense you purchase on that. So I'm just going to name it as Verizon, and it's cash. You can test the rule, love to test the rule. And you can do auto, or you can just leave it to show the categorization, and then you just add. I like the auto. So we have the payee over here. We can go ahead and add that. Walmart, we're going to put cleaning supplies maybe. Or just office expense. Okay. Walmart, let's suppose I don't want to create a rule because I have different things that I buy at Walmart. So let's see, Costco is correct. Tips, look at this. QuickBooks AI is trying to categorize the same thing as in the past. And let's say that's how I want to do it. Or like I said, if you want to track the name of the employees that you're paying, you can do so. You can put, you know, under the description, and then you'll know how to categorize without having to look. Look at this, you just click on add instead of having to manually add all those transactions in there. Okay, public. All right. Publix, let's suppose that is office supply as well. Okay, Publix is a popular supermarket here on the East Coast, especially Florida. I'm not being paid by Publix, by the way, but they have some good food and I definitely like to visit them sometimes. My kids love it, love their sandwiches. Okay. Let's see, tips income. So this is going to be income. Let's suppose you're depositing the tips at the end of the day. So here it is. I'm going to put cash tips. Just create cash tips here. And that's definitely not... So I'm just going to put under undistributed tips. This is going to be actually a liability. So it's saying that I'm receiving those tips. I'm not paying yet. This is just receiving the tip and recording the liability, okay? So that's all there is to it. So you can even go to bank register right from here and reconcile, just like you reconcile any other account. How cool is that? I absolutely love this feature, and it makes your life a lot easier. If you are a business owner, you just have to keep track of all your cash expense on the Excel. Let's go back here. So we're done here. We're done with QuickBooks. Okay, I am back. Okay, so if you're a business owner, like I said, you want to keep all your expense recorded nicely on Excel spreadsheet and save it as a CSV file, Excel type. And then, like I said, format is very important. So you want to keep the format nice and clean. You can put different things, but you want to make sure you have at least three columns for those transactions. Okay, you can add a fourth column under checks, and under check you can put the transaction number. If it is check, you can put check number. Whatever it is, you can put some extra information in there so you can know what it is. Under the description, usually that's where I put what this expense is for. You know, if it is tips payable, you want to keep track of the employee. You want to put the employee name slash tips. If it is, let's suppose you're sending your employee to buy some groceries with cash and you're not keeping track, or maybe they're buying with their own funds and you're just reimbursing them cash. And you're taking out of your cash drawer. So yeah, so you can put the information, oh, this is groceries. And then you put the name of the vendor, Publix, Walmart, whatever you want to put. And then you can go ahead into QuickBooks, just import that, just like any bank feed. Isn't that fantastic? Saves you ton of time. So you don't have to go and enter one by one, just have to keep track on that on the Excel spreadsheet. So if you're a business owner, just at the end of the month, import that. If you're an accountant or if you're a bookkeeper, ask your business owner to keep track of things this way. This way you can just quickly import into QuickBooks and categorize those transactions like a breeze. Isn't that awesome? All right. So my main goal here is to help you, if you're a business owner, to be able to understand the financials of your business. Bring your business finance up to date and make sure that everything is correct. So this way you know your point of reference. We always talk about the point of reference. How important is that? You need to know where you are. You know, knowing financially where you are is as important as you are geographically, so you know where you want to go. Okay, it's kind of like turning on the light. You need to turn on the light to see where you're going. Same thing. I mean, you gotta know your finances. If you're walking in the dark, just turn on your light. Keep your books up to date. If you need help, we do offer bookkeeping service ongoing and clean up, and also a 101 tutorial if you want to do it yourself. But if you want to get rid of it and you just want to pass on this information so you can run your business, yeah, just contact us. We will have our contact down below. If you're a bookkeeper, accountant, and you want to learn more, about QuickBooks and how to manage it, yes, we offer that one-on-one tutorial as well. We can train your employees as well. So, thanks for watching and taking this time with me. I'm so excited to be spending another year with you. And like I said, this year we are pushing towards doubling the number of content in this channel. So if you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, please do so. This is free content. You want this free content to continue coming to you and helping you stay up to date, train your employees or do whatever employees or do whatever you need to do. Just subscribe to our channel, share with your family and friends. We want to help as many people as possible, and you have no idea how much you're helping me just by clicking subscribe. We're going to continue. I have a promise that I will make to you, that I'll continue to improve myself and continue to increase my skills so I can share it with you. That's what I want. I want to see you succeed. So please subscribe to our channel, and I'm going to come back pretty soon. And until next time, keep on smiling.